Hi everyone, this is AsBayonetta, back with another video. Let's talk about the inspiration behind your favorite Disney characters. It's no secret that before some of the characters appeared on paper, the creators were inspired by real people. Some characters are often inspired by the voice actors. And I think that you also noticed this when you watch some cartoon. This is the reason why you thought these Disney characters seemed familiar. But sometimes there were several inspirations for one character, like Ariel, Belle, or Aladdin. But who actually was the real inspiration to them? Let's find out! And of course, don't forget to subscribe to watch more interesting videos. Okay, here we go! Ariel from The Little Mermaid was inspired by an actress Alyssa Milano and live-action model for the character Sherry Stoner, including some of her movements. Sherry Stoner was also used as the model for Belle in Beauty and the Beast. But there is more. Belle's yellow dress was inspired by Audrey Hepburn's dress in Roman Holiday. Next we have Ursula, the witch from The Little Mermaid. Her design was inspired by Harris Glenn Milstead, best known as drag queen Divine, who is still the inspiration for many fictional characters. Lumiere from Beauty and the Beast was inspired by Maurice Chevalier. And Jerry Orbach, who voiced Lumiere, also imitated him. Aladdin's face was based on Tom Cruise. But in early visual development, Aladdin resembled Michael J. Fox. So you can see an early Aladdin design during Friend Like Me song, because it was the first animated scene in Aladdin to be completed. Also, Aladdin's slow cut baggy pants movements was inspired by MC Hammer. You can touch this. Princess Jasmine's facial features were inspired by Beth Allen, who is the sister of supervising animator Mark Henn. But her eyebrows were inspired by actress Jennifer Connelly. Tony Goldwyn, who voiced Disney's Tarzan, was the inspiration for his face, especially his eyes. The same thing with Tarzan's friend Turk, who was by Rosie O'Donnell. Yes, Turk is a girl. Genie from Aladdin was totally inspired by his voice actor, Robin Williams. Esmeralda in The Hunchback of Notre Dame was inspired by her voice actress, Demi Moore. Pocahontas was inspired by actress Irene Bedard, who was also the voice behind the character. American actress Margaret Qualley was the inspiration and reference model for Tinker Bell in Peter Pan. An American dancer and actress, Marsh Champion, served as the real-life model for Snow White in Disney's Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs when she was only 14 years old. But she wasn't the only one who influenced Snow White's design. There was also Austrian actress Hedy Lamarr. Vultures in 1967's The Jungle Book were inspired by The Beatles. Shenzi's design from The Lion King was inspired by Whoopi Goldberg, who also voiced the character. Adult Simba's mane in The Lion King was inspired by Jon Bon Jovi's hair. Princess Tiana in The Princess and the Frog was based on Anika Noni Rose, an American actress and singer, who was also her voice. John Goodman was used for inspiration of Pacha in The Emperor's New Groove. He was also the voice of this character. Aurora, Cinderella, and Anita were drawn from Helen Stanley, who performed the live-action references for these Disney characters. Peter Pan was modeled after Bobby Driscoll. He was also Peter's voice and his animation model. Wendy Darling and Alice were inspired by just one person, Katherine Beaumont. She was the voice and live-action reference model for these characters. Zazu inspired by his voice actor Rowan Atkinson. He is just like him, and his British accent is simply amazing. Hades from 1997's Hercules was inspired by his voice actor James Woods. So as you can see, Hades definitely looks like James, including his movements. The same story with Phil from Hercules, who was voiced by Danny DeVito. There's nothing to say. When I look at Phil, I see Danny. The facial features of the March Hare in Alice in Wonderland were based on Jerry Colonna. He was also the voice behind the character. The animators of the Evil Queen in Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs drew inspiration from the Hollywood Queen, American film and television actress Joan Crawford. But the Queen's gown resembles the outfit used by Helen Gehagen Douglas in the 1935 film She. The look of Maleficent in Sleeping Beauty was mainly inspired by Mela Nerny's character Vampyra, who took most of her inspiration from Morticia Adams and the Evil Queen. Supervising animator Mark Davis and his team relied on the personality and gestures of Tallulah Bankhead to design Cruella de Vil for a 101 Dalmatians. Well, that's all. I just want to ask, which character do you think most closely resembles his inspiration? Please comment below. Don't forget to subscribe and see you next time. Bye!